WGN Investigates traffic troubles at O Hare as rideshare vehicles pack roads leading into the busy airport.
The mess is leaving customers waiting for as long as an hour for a ride. Lourdes Duarte looked into why it's been such a tough issue to fix out there.
Yeah, we looked at some numbers on this. If the airport's estimates are correct, O Hare gets 15 rideshare pickups and drop-offs per minute. Drivers can make big money at airports, and they know that. In the last 3 years, ride shares have quadrupled at O'Hare from 160,000 trips to 650,000 each month. Unfortunately, it hasn't been a smooth ride. Take a look.
The skies over O'Hare Airport are noisy, but it's what's happening on the ground that's an earful. It's a big name, but this is O'Hare's Transportation Network Provider lot, also known as a TNP lot.
Have you seen the lot yet?
Come with us as we crawl our way inside that rideshare vehicle waiting area.
This isn't even that bad right now.
For months, five-year driver Eli Martin has been complaining about it, and here's why. This is the lot on a random Friday morning. Busy, but nothing compared to Thursday nights.
People get wild here. I've seen fistfights break out here.
In a YouTube video, you hear just that.
You are not in the lane.
It doesn't matter. You're not blind, are you, sir?
No, I'm not blind, but you need to move over. You blocking two parking spots.
There's 20 spots up.
I want to be here.
Posted to Twitter, a crash outside the lot. And look at this video on a different day, what looks like a mile-long backup.
When it's bad, see, it's backed up all the way here. I can't even get in that row.
This is happening regularly, frustrating back at the terminal as well for customers left standing by.
I don't know, I'm trying to like even get a hold of her.
Yes, where are you at?
There's been challenges with drivers taking upwards of 20 to 30 minutes to come get you.
WGN Investigates obtained some of the driver receipts that detail those waits. Look at this one. A driver made the request at 5:11. Pickup came at 6:07. That's nearly an hour later. What's worse is that when the customer looks at the estimated pickup times, the app doesn't take into account any of those traffic backups back at the lot. So what you think is a 5-minute wait turns into much longer.
It's on us then to call them and say, hey, I know what the app said. It's no fault of my own. It's going to be 25 or 30 minutes. Would you please wait for me?
Huge line trying to get out.
We took the video and the stories to the two aldermen leading the city's aviation committee, Alderman Gilbert Villegas and Matt O'Shea.
I know we're the busiest airport and stuff like that, but there has to be some type of limit on the amount of Uber and Lyft drivers that are going to the airport because this is just causing too much congestion.
I think we need to look at everything because, O'Hare is one of the largest travel hubs in North America.
A fix hasn't been that easy. The city's aviation department and the rideshare companies have known about issues at the lot for months, but still no results. And the drivers, well, they've had it.
Six different lanes trying to combine into one.
That's affecting my business as well because time is money.
The people that are making all the money off us have to, put some of that money back into the infrastructure.
If you do the math, the city collects about $5 for each rideshare pickup and drop-off at O'Hare. If they estimate there's about 650,000 of those a month, that's $39 million a year. But forget the math for now. The aviation department's chief operating officer is working on a fix for that messy lot. For starters, a traffic light at that intersection. And it won't happen overnight, but an additional waiting lot.
We have such a large program of construction going on at O'Hare that we need to phase things so that we're not interfering with other projects that are coming up.
But as the days tick on, the list of rideshare vehicles grows. By now, they well outnumber the 7,000 Chicago cabs with 65,000 city-registered rideshare drivers, which leads to the question.
At some point, do you stop those rideshares from coming in, meaning you set a limit on how many come into the airport?
So I think your question is really about policy, and I would say to you that, all options are on the table. We'll look at the entire spectrum of options that we have.
It's an option they made a reality in New York, and one that even Eli has considered.
You need a driver cap. You need some type of regulation so that it's not just chaotic.
It's not clear if that will happen. What is clear is that the industry is an undeniable part of Chicago's economy, and there's no looking back.
Uber and Lyft say they are working with the aviation department on a fix. Both their statements are on our website, WGNTV.com. I've also been talking to aviation officials for the last few weeks on this. The alderman for that ward said they were working on a temporary light to go up as soon as possible at that intersection. You see the video right behind me. It was shot late this afternoon. It was pretty calm out there because so many flights have been canceled at O'Hare today. However, still no traffic light, which means the problem is not quite over yet. So we'll have to keep following it.
Look at that logjam. It's just so it sounds like other cities may do different things. Have they tried any other systems here?
Well, they did one other system before this, and the problem was that there was congestion a little closer to the terminal, which is the reason why they switched to this. But then the congestion has just moved to another area. So we'll have to come up with something else. We'll see.
All right. Thank you.